Hello, Cloud Gurus. This week we have a massive announcement. AWS Proton is now generally available. Get it? Massive. And we have what seems like a mole of additional headlines to bring you after that. I'm Matthias Anderson, and you're watching AWS This Week. But just quickly before we get into the news, I would love for you to help us out by filling in a short survey. We genuinely want to bring you the best YouTube content we can, so please let us know what you think. Do you like it when we run through the headlines? Or add more detail? Include more news or stick to just our very favorite announcements? And beyond this show, what else do you like? We can't read your mind, so you'll have to let us know. You'll find a link to our survey in the description down below. Okay, we could tease that it's the little things that matter, but this is actually a pretty positive announcement. AWS Proton is now generally available. AWS describes Proton as a fully managed delivery service for container and serverless applications designed to provide platform teams the management tools, governance, and visibility needed to provide consistent standards and best practices when managing deployments. Woo! The key here is that this is aimed at the platform team in an organization, enabling them to build and manage both environments and service templates that they can then offer to service developers. Those service devs don't need to be experts at setting up AWS infrastructure or deployment pipelines or monitoring or anything like that. They can just focus on their own service, and the platform teams can then manage those environments and template-based services over time as they make updates and publish new versions of their platform components. This can be a strong force multiplier for your cloud team if you have one. Anyway, this is supposed to be a short news show, so I suggest that you might want to follow up on this by reading the two blog posts that we at A-Cloud Guru published about this when AWS Proton was released into preview last reInvent. Links in the description up, down below. Wait, if we're doing chemistry jokes, should I call them bonds instead of links? In any case, despite being about Proton, there's no charge to read them. And finally, I'll add that with its release to GA, AWS Proton has gotten a couple of extra goodies. One is that it can now manage your environments across multiple AWS accounts, so you can do things like limit the blast radius of dev to a different account from prod. Good, right? The second is that AWS Proton APIs now support IAM condition context keys, so you can use template characteristics to determine which devs can use which templates to make their services. Color me impressed! Okay, now let's fly through a bunch of headlines at the speed of light. Hold on to your hats and feel free to turn back down the video playback speed. Amazon DocumentDB with MongoDB compatibility now supports global clusters. AWS Lambda extensions are now generally available. AWS China Beijing region now has a third availability zone. Amazon SNS now supports SMS sandbox, including Incognito, so that you can safely test SMS notifications. Amazon Cognito now supports targeted signout through refresh token revocation. Amazon EKS pods running on AWS Fargate now support custom security groups. AWS Transit Gateway increases its service level agreement from 99.95% to 99.99. 3.5 nines is now 4. Amazon FSx for Windows File Server now has file access auditing. AWS Systems Manager is now FedRAMP High compliant. Amazon EMR Studio, an IDE for data science, is now available in 13 regions. Amazon SageMaker Data Wrangler now supports Snowflake as a data source. Amazon SageMaker Model Registry now supports rollback of deployed models. Amazon SageMaker Pipeline now supports callback capability, so you can include external processing in your model builds. Amazon Managed Blockchain now supports customer-managed customer master keys, CMKs. Amazon Athena Engine version 2 is now generally available in all Athena regions. And finally, though it may seem minor to some, it's a welcome development for others. NAT gateways no longer need an internet gateway for private communications. Whew! Okay, that sure is a lot, but you should know that we at A-Cloud Guru have a free 7-day trial available for anyone thinking about getting into cloud. We have hundreds of courses on AWS, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud, plus Linux, DevOps, Kubernetes, and loads more. There's a link below if you're interested, so please take a look. Also, I'd like to give you a special challenge today. Comment down below to call out any chemistry or physics references you caught me making in this video. I suggest you do that relatively soon after you like and subscribe, and a moment before you collide with all the links we've included. Well, that's all the news for this week. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and keep being positively awesome, cloud gurus. Hey, thanks for coming. All right, okay, so a proton sits down and orders a drink. Hey, just water, please. What? Are you sure? Oh yes, it replies. I'm positive.